What's going on? My name is Jason Parks of the Media Captain. Today I'm going to talk Performance Max campaigns on Google Ads. When you think of Performance Max, think of it as combining all of your advertisements into one centralized place. You can run shopping, you can run PPC, you can run display. Rather than setting up a lot of different campaigns, it's more centralized. Performance Max might seem like the easy route to take and just serve ads for all of your products, but I want to walk you through this so you understand how to set up Performance Max and allow for you to go through a critical thinking journey with me to understand whether or not this is the right move for your Google Ads campaign. So let's dive into it. All right, so it's time to set up our Performance Max campaigns. In this example, it's going to be for Derm Warehouse, our in-house e-commerce brand. What makes our agency unique? We have over 400,000 customers with our in-house e-commerce brand, in addition to helping a lot of clients on the agency side. So let's dive into it. All right, so you're in Google Ads and you're going to create a campaign. And obviously, this is going to be a new campaign. When it comes to Performance Max, you're going to want to go for sales. So that's obviously important. You want to drive revenue. Make sure when you're looking at the conversion goals to improve sales, we like just having purchases. A lot of times it might import a lot of different conversion actions that you have, such as add to cart or contact form submissions. Obviously, for an e-commerce company, the only thing we want the campaign to be optimized for is for purchases. So make sure to audit this. Make sure to select purchases and remove other goals that are unnecessary. All right, so then you're going to go to continue. And here you're going to select the campaign type. And so here is the option for Performance Max. And that's obviously what we want. So let's click on that. All right, and you will see that to advertise products on your website, select a Merchant Center account. The Derm Warehouse Merchant Center is obviously what needs to be synced so our Google Shopping ads can run. So that's important. And let's just call this, PMax Derm Warehouse. All right, so now it's time to continue and create a new campaign or finish a saved draft. So we're gonna start new. All right, so then into the bidding, what do you wanna focus on? Conversions, set a target cost per action. You'll see that based off of conversions. For conversion value, that's what I like to do, and I recommend setting a target return on ad spend. You'll see 320. A lot of people get greedy with their target ROAS. I recommend starting at 150 or 200 just to get conversions coming through the door, and then you can always increase it. So that's just a recommendation. All right, this down here is really important, customer acquisition. Optimize for campaign for acquiring new customers. When it comes to customer acquisition, obviously optimize the campaign for acquiring new customers. And I like bidding higher for new customers than for existing customers. Then at that point, you're getting the best of both worlds. Google's obviously optimizing for new customers, but it still might bid on brand a little bit. So we are going to go to next. All right, in the campaign settings, I'm gonna choose United States. For the language, it's gonna be English. Automatically created assets, it's fine just keeping that selected. And for right now, I'm just gonna keep the ad schedule as is, and I'm gonna go to next. All right, next is the asset group. This is really important. This is where you're gonna come up with all of your creative. And a mistake a lot of people do with Performance Max is they just put all of their products in a Performance Max campaign. When you create a Performance Max campaign, it overtakes your existing Google Shopping campaign. So if you have a current Google Shopping campaign that's running and it has a strong return on ad spend, do not create a Performance Max campaign because it will just start from scratch and it can hinder your data and performance. So what I recommend doing is take a subset of products that maybe isn't performing well in your standard shopping campaign and start there with Performance Max to see how that does. In this instance, Park Perfection is a brand that we carry. It's actually a brand that we developed. And in this Performance Max campaign, I am going to segment out Park Perfection within this specific PMax campaign. So let's dive through it. So for the asset group name, I'm gonna call this Park Perfection. Okay, so here you'll see the listing group, and this is important. It has all products. I don't want to do all products because we have other Google Shopping campaigns that are performing well that have a lot of data. So I'm going to use a selection of products, and I am then going to go by brand, and I am going to search for Park Perfection. Okay, so Park Perfection, we have 6 products in that brand, which is correct. So we're going to save that. Okay, and so this is great. Like I mentioned, it is only going to serve Park Perfection products within this Performance Max campaign. So now you'll start to see that where the advertisements for Performance Max get served, it's YouTube, it's Gmail ads, it's Google search ads, it's display, it's Discover. So, you know, I mentioned earlier how it combines everything into one centralized campaign. That is the beauty of Performance Max. So you can see, and by the way, I've pre-filled a lot of information just to save some time, but I'm going to go through each step for you. You go down here, and for the final URL, again, this is the Park Perfection line that we're serving. So I don't just want it going to Durham Warehouse. I want the final URL going to Park Perfection. I've mentioned with Performance Max that it pulls everything into a it makes all of the campaigns centralized. So you could see that this is going to run on YouTube. This is going to run on Gmail. This is going to run on Google Search. This is going to run on display. And I'll show you the creative elements a little bit later. But what you're doing now is coming up with all of the creative for Performance Max within here. So the images, I just want to show you. This is pretty cool. When you select images, it already, based off of the final URL, it is already giving me like the products to select, which is our Park Perfection products, which is fantastic. So that saves a lot of time. But if it's not pulling in the right products, you could always upload that. For the logo, this is just going to be the Durham Warehouse logo because this is the website that we're serving it from. And for the video, you know, this serves as YouTube. So we have a Park Perfection video. You can see here, Park Perfection Instant Eye Lift. So we're serving that video. And I've created the headlines, Park Perfection Skincare, carried at Nordstrom. That's a big credibility factor for us. We've been featured on InStyle, another big credibility factor. Long headlines. This is where I've highlighted our products. Instant Eye Lift, Pore Perfector, Lash Enhancing Serum. There are descriptions as well. So, you know, it starts to become familiar to you when you're creating these Performance Max campaigns because it feels kind of like just setting up a regular, you know, PPC or shopping campaign, but everything's just combined into one. You know, the business name here for the site links, it's pulling in the account level site links, but you could create all of this. One thing, if you're running a shopping campaign, I would recommend rather than, automated, I would recommend going to Shop Now for the call to action. All right, audience signal is something that you need for Performance Max campaigns. It just needs to have an audience associated with the campaign. So if you're not seeing it already pulled in, you can create an audience signal. I'm just gonna call this Park Perfection. And I like doing my data because I want it to target ads based off of people who have purchased on my website. So here you could see conversions over the past 30 days. So I'm just gonna select that and I'm gonna save this. And once you do that, you can then proceed to the next step. All right, so in terms of the budget, it gives you a recommended budget. You could set a custom budget. Since this is for just 6 products and we wanna see whether or not we can prove concept and get a strong ROAS, we're gonna set the budget for $30 a day. We're gonna go to next. And then it pretty much just summarizes everything within your campaign. You'll see there's an error within the asset group. I just have to go back and fix an image. And it will tell you if there's an error that occurred, it will tell you where to go. And then you're at the end of Performance Max. Once you fix the error, you can press launch and your PMax campaigns will be up and running. In closing, Performance Max, it's the wave of the future with Google Shopping. I definitely recommend getting set up on Performance Max. Just be cautious. I would do a subset of products on Performance Max before moving to all of your products because you don't want to impact past campaigns that were performing well. Also, Performance Max, The data is not as strong as standard Google Shopping campaigns per se. You don't have insight into search terms and some other key data points. So that's a negative on Performance Max, but overall, Google's machine learning, hop on board with it. It's gonna help out. Just take it in baby steps. My name is Jason Parks with The Media Captain. If you ever have any questions, you can contact me at themediacaptain.com.